Traditionally, to get a taxi in Brighton, you'd hail a cab from the street or ring up the relevant company. But Uber's bid to get a share of the city's commuters will see the way we use taxis change forever. However, its app-based service has caused controversy around the world, with concerns raised over security, with many current taxi drivers seeing Uber as unfair competition. And those concerns were shared earlier this week at a meeting set out to decide whether the company can operate in the city. That decision was put on hold.
What we don't want to see happen today is for this to be deferred and conditions being attached to their licence, because that makes it an unfair playing field, not only to the companies within Brighton, but also to the citizens in Brighton. When they phone up for a car, if they've got any form of disability, that car should be there within minutes. It should be the car they requested. The call should be taken by an operator who knows exactly how they're going to serve that, whether the call is taken here in Brighton or whether it's taken in the Netherlands.
As a Brightonian, all I can say is that we all know the busy times in Brighton, the Friday nights, the Saturday nights, where people may be tempted to use them, but if they have to pay, you know, double what they pay in a taxi, the market will find its own level. As I say, we welcome competition, but it must be on a level playing field, and all our disabled customers, and there are many of them in Brighton, we work with all disability groups and we're proud to do so. And this is the way. If you provide a service, it must be for every single resident in Brighton and not just a select few.
Uber already operates in 8 cities across the country. Its use of app-based services revolutionises traditional means of getting from A to B. Local technology firms are welcoming the company's innovation into the city.
I think it's absolutely a good thing. I think it's part of a wider economic picture. So we're seeing lots of these kind of platforms emerge that let people start their own businesses really quickly and quit their 9-to-5 job and go off and do what they want to do. So I think it's more about that than any kind of technicality. It's about enabling freelancers to do what they want to do. And I think the economy's already there, and it's basically a question of legislation catching up.
Uber said on Monday that they would meet all regulations that other taxi operators in Brighton and Hove comply with. The City Council say they're likely to release their decision at the end of the week.